Hello and welcome to The Walking Dead. This game was gifted to me from a friend of mine, the ever so awesome General Cookie. And I've already played quite a bit. I've got a good hour and a half already into the game. So I really wanted to get the feel, and by get the feel, I pretty much got lost into the story. So I'm going to start it over from the beginning. And there's that.
Glenn will remember you lied. Don't lie to Glenn.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
You know what they say about reckoning?
I don't, but I reckon it's a lot like assuming.
Yeah, something like that.
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't.
We got what looks like a 1091E near Peachtree, exit 285.
Your Peachtree.
All cars have to keep on the lookout for a 91E in the area.
And, oh, shit, not even paying attention.
I followed your case a little bit, you being a Macon boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case, like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in, with all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
He advised medical personnel
it's getting cold. Suddenly getting cold.
I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
There we go.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Riot in progress. All officers are available for incoming.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it. That box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming 21.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. That's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over.
Mm-hmm.
I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Oh, shit!
This other time...
Come on. There we go.
I need to drag myself out that window.
Okay, then fucking do it. Come on, Lee.
Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off. Officer? God damn.
Deader than a Schrodinger's cat. No way in hell.
Officer? Holy shit!
What? Shit! Well, that's it. Game over, guys. Okay, it's over with. Bye.
Officer. Holy shit! Get away from me! Shit! Make me do this!
smells like shit. What the hell is this?
Help! Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
In the house. Come on. Come on. Any day now. There you go.
Hello? Anybody?
It's a nice pool. In said we go.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Hello? I'm not an intruder. One of them.
These people may need more help than I do. It's fate. Damn.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3. Left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Daddy?
Huh?
I don't even remember where I found the walkie-talkie. Oh, there it is.
Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. How old are you?
8.
And you're all alone?
Yes. I don't know where anybody is. How old are you?
I'm, 37.
Okay.
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
This must be Sandra. I think it might be dead now. We can double check. You know, double tap. You always gotta make sure.
Man. Hi there.
Did you kill it?
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
Controlling him right now is so clunky. This is his fucking leg.
Oh, man.
I ain't never getting home to mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Well, let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
Do you know what the hell this is?
No idea. So you've seen them then?
You could say that.
I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. I'm just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
I...
The monster's coming.
We gotta go. Leave quick. Let's go.
I like how he couldn't walk before, but now he's just pushing his fucking car.
Turn!
For just some guy, it seems like you saved a bunch of lives today. No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you, then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well, just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where were you headed before the car accident?
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer. He was giving me a ride.
Awful nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son's right. You're gonna want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I saw a cop come back from the dead.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
shit. I'm sorry. I shouldn't talk like that.
That was a swear. I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
I love you, baby.